I've been feeling very different today. I don't know what's going on, but I'm just going to take over.
Amen.
That's all I can do, and that's all I know how to do. So, I'm going to read from Colossians chapter 1, verse 11 to 13. It says, Strengthen with all might according to his glorious power, unto all patience and long suffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father which hath made us meet to be partaker of the inheritance of the saints in light, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. Everybody that overcomes something, whether it be medicine, hurt, abandonment, drugs, anything, you need strength. And the only person you can get strength from is him. Now, I'm being very honest. I never knew what this was my whole life. My mother, God rest her soul, went to church using her in churches, always just trying to get what she needed. I don't know nothing about the Bible. I never read it before. I bought this Bible when I had to come see him because I didn't know. Someone was like, "Sister, you don't get a Bible." And I'm like, "I don't need that." I've always had my faith. When I had cancer, when I was 20, when I was pregnant with my daughter, I dropped down when they told me I was pregnant and I had cancer and that I need to abort my child. And I looked at that doctor and I said, "Take the needles out of my arm because I'm not doing that. That is a sin. I am not doing that. You gave me this child, and that's all I know, and I'm going to carry her." Well, 5 years later, my daughter is healthy, and I am healthy.
Amen. Come on.
And the only thing I needed was strength. I have watched my parents use drugs. I have been homeless. I have been through it all. But all I needed was strength and my faith. And I just have to say this, but I don't know why I can't. You will never need to look to another pill again. And no matter if anything happens in this world, you don't need medication to keep your mind narrow and straight for God. They said I had bipolar. It wasn't bipolar. The world was bipolar. Okay? I don't need PhD medicine. I'm happy. I'm fine. Just because I like to have fun and dance and do things don't mean I have ADHD. That just means I'm a fun person and I don't like to be miserable. Scott, my best friend, the one that pushed me through from when I was a kid. When I jumped on them kids, when they cursed me out and I would fight them because that's all I knew how to do. And my best friend told me, "Cecil, come see me for your child right now. You ain't doing it. You ain't making me." And I did it anyway. He didn't force me, he told me one time. And I have now, going on a year, have not used my hands to hurt another person that I don't physically know. I mean, yes, I must have, you know, that's just me. But I have not hurt anyone. I have not put anybody in the hospital. I have cried, but I have pulled through it. What you need is strength, faith, and your love. That's the only thing that's going to get you through. Nothing else. Anybody can sit there and say, "Lady Anika, you're not a mother. That's going to make you want to lose your mind. You could go back to using." But no, you stop. You get on your knees and you pray.
Amen.
When the doctor sat there and told me, "Cecil, I had a cyst on my brain. We're going to have to do brain surgery. That thing busted." Because I prayed. I got on my knees. And one thing that's always kept with me is when I went to a service in New Jersey with Delaney, Pastor Delaney, and he said, "Do what you know. Praise." The first time I ever prayed was in February right here. And that's what I did. And I said, "It's not going to happen. That's just busted. Yes, my hair is now growing back.
Good God.
I am not accepting anything that says, hey, so your body's going to fail. Because guess what? It's not. And it's going to keep getting better. Because nothing's going to stop me. Because I have what? Strength, faith, and I love God. And that's all I know. And I didn't even know this. And now I'm here. Right where I belong.